Hey guys, today we're talking all about screw piles, also known as helical piers, also known as screw pier foundations. Now, whatever name you give these crafty monster ground screws, this week I'm digging in to find out exactly what they're all about, how you can make use of them, and the pros and cons to screw piles, and a look at the impacts these products have on our planet, our wallet, and our health. Let's do it. Now, before we get into the video, all you homeowners out there who've had experiences with screw piles, we want to hear all about it. So please comment in the box below and remember to give the video a quick like and hit that subscribe button for the latest. So this summer, like a lot of you, I've got big plans for our family's backyard. From a brand new two-tier deck to patio slabs to retaining walls, it's safe to say that this boring backyard will soon be turned into a super fun backyard for the whole family and one we can entertain in. Now, before this project got started, I had a lot of questions. And one of the first questions that came up was, how are we going to support this new deck we were putting up? Just for context here, we're building a two-tier deck attached to the house on one side with two platforms, one about 3 feet off the ground to meet up with these sliding doors, and another at ground level to meet up with this service door. So altogether, this deck adds just over 300 square feet of exterior living space to our house, and our priorities were clear. We want this thing to last as long as possible, and we want it to be as low maintenance as possible. And part of that is making sure it has a long-lasting foundation that is resilient to the elements and that's not gonna shift over time. So first things first, what the heck are screw piles? Screw piles, or helical piers, are a type of foundation system that's been around since as far back as the 1800s, which hints as to how much of a lifespan these things have. They're essentially a giant galvanized steel shaft with screw-like flanges that are twisted into the ground. They're twisted deep enough, just enough, so that the torque required to turn it indicates a proper bearing capacity of that soil. Now, usually they're installed to go just below the frost line, but sometimes can even go hundreds of feet deep depending on your soil conditions. Now, some of the most common applications for screw piles include piers, basement walls, perimeter beams, and even slabs. So keep in mind that as we're talking about helical piers for a new backyard deck today, this isn't the only application, but it is arguably the most common for homeowners to be familiar with. These piers can be driven into most types of ground, but solid rock does require some pre-drilling and also will add to your cost. Stony soils are okay as well, but sometimes you might hit a large rock enough to have to start the process all over again and reposition the screw. All right, so what are some of the pros to installing screw piles? So screw piles are super fast to put in. It's kind of like an instant foundation. It works in a variety of soil conditions, and the install is also pretty cost effective. Not many parts are involved. I should add also, it's relatively low in embodied energy, and it's pretty non-intrusive. So some of the disadvantages to screw piles, while they're an easy install, screw piles, they're not a DIY job, so you'll need specialized machinery to install it. And I'll actually show you an alternative to that in just a minute. Now, the price. Now here in Eastern Canada, we're paying on average $250 per standard helical pier. And that price includes the full installation, brackets, and a nice little engineering report at the end. So you know that the piers are rightly sized, rightly torqued, and will stay in the ground without shifting for decades, if not centuries to come. Now, some of you may say that's a hefty price to pay for a single pier, and you might be right, but consider this. By comparison, a concrete pier, which is another common pier, this time where a hole is dug and concrete is poured, is likely the most commonly used alternative for backyards and other pier applications. So here are some more numbers to throw at you to consider if you're installing these for a deck or a large structure like this. Concrete piers, on average, for material cost, you're looking at about $70 per pier. Time to install is 2 to 3 days that concrete needs to cure. Labor costs are between $30 and $230 and will depend on your machinery and the time to install, which will vary depending on your soil conditions. And for those who say, I'm going to install these myself, keep in mind that a lot can go wrong with concrete pier installs and really how much is your time worth to you? Because, well, you're gonna need lots of it for this job. So at the end of the day, $250 doesn't sound like that bad now, does it? Especially for that peace of mind that your foundation won't be going anywhere anytime soon. Okay, so like everything else we do at Rise, we love to consider the planet impact on materials and products. So a couple of things to consider with helical piers. One, most of the embodied energy that goes into making helical piers is found in the harvesting and manufacturing process, and a bit in the transportation. They're typically made from steel and coated with zinc and requires high sources of heat to construct. Now, one plus though is that waste from this manufacturing process is still quite low and mostly from offcuts. That said, the overall embodied energy from helical piers is still relatively low, and that's also thanks to its insulation process, which is super straightforward and really not intrusive. Now, durability and longevity is also key to helical piers' low impact in that they do typically last a very, very long time. And durability usually depends on the quality of the pier as well as the soil in which they're placed. And lastly, on the health impact side, steel piers have very little to no impact on its surroundings from a health perspective. Typically, we'd look at any potential off-gassing from the material or any potential contamination to the soil in which they're placed. This is also a really good reason to pick a galvanized finish over a painted one. All right, so a quick little sidebar here. Here's something that I learned for smaller structures, so things like pergolas or even ground level decks might work with this option. I call these DIY helical piers. You can find them at almost any local hardware store for about $25 to $30 each. Non-standard brackets though are extra, by the way, and they work essentially the same way as the helical piers we installed earlier, but with one big difference. You can actually install these yourself. And to demonstrate that, I recruited the help of my oldest daughter, Audrey, to spin around in circles with me to install this giant ground screw. Let's do it. Well, that was a fail. We went about halfway and hit a big giant rock, and there's no getting by it, and therein lies getting a proper installer. So we give up on this one. Again, you'll want to check your local building requirements and whether these helical piers are acceptable for your project. So looking at these up close though, they're visibly smaller than the helical piers we had installed for the deck. The other big unknown here is whether we're truly successful with our install. By not knowing the actual torque that's required to turn the pier into place, we don't actually know just how much weight these piers will support, which is why you may only want to consider these for smaller projects. Another thing I noticed with these smaller helical piers was the finish, which was powder coated in comparison to the typical galvanized steel finish that is found with other piers. And that does have a longevity advantage over paint. All right, so what's the best way to ensure a successful screw pile install? Well, for one, you'll want to get a helical pier contractor involved super early in the process. Sizing the right pier shafts can have a big impact on your project costs. And so knowing where you'll place the piers and how many you're going to need is totally essential. Number two, in a perfect world, getting a geotechnical survey done before committing to helical piers is ideal. That said, you may be able to skip this step for smaller projects like a deck build or a scenario where a pier contractor is familiar with the area's soil conditions already. So number three, make sure that the brackets supplied with the helical piers are compatible with your project, or else you might have to buy a brand new bracket to help support what you're building. So number four, double checking with your local building department is a really good idea too, to make sure you're meeting all of your code requirements. Usually a sign of a good helical pier contractor is one who will provide you an engineering stamp with the work, which you may need to actually bring to your local building department for sign off anyway. And five, make sure you've prepared ahead by calling before you dig for potential underground wires or pipes. Your helical pier contractor may ask you to do that ahead of time anyway, but aside from electrical or gas lines, be aware of anything else that may be hiding underground. I caught an issue at the very last minute with our yard where we had a drain tile exit in the exact spot of one of our piers. Oh. Here, there is a There's a pipe underneath here. It was an easy fix to reposition the pier and something that could have caused some extensive damage. Now that we've reached the end of our video today about helical piers, please don't forget to leave your comments. And as always, find more videos and resources like this one at buildwithrise.com, the online authority in sustainable home improvement. Thanks again for checking this out, guys, and we will catch you on the next one.
Peace.
Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the button below, and also check out buildwithrise.com, the only place to turn any home improvement project into a sustainable one.